多美国公司以合并收购的名义迁进海外，而被美国各界认为是有意避税的行为，使这些公司遭到了不爱国的责骂。那么美国财政部呢，在上周一就做出了一个迁进海外公司税务待遇方面的新的办法，力图打击这种避税的行为。而办法公布之后，许多涉嫌的公司当天股价都出现大跌。除去心理因素之外，财政部此举到底有什么效率？对美国政府的税收是不是有正面提升的意义呢？今天我们就请到了美孚律师事务所洪兆基律师为我们进行解读。
In America, we have a worldwide taxation system, meaning money that is earned overseas, when you bring it back to America, it will still be taxed. Now, that is the case where you have a U.S. corporation as the head of the group.Because then things underneath it will be things that it owns, so when it brings it back to America, you have to pay tax of it. But flip the situation around, if you have a foreign company be the head of the group, then for the money that is earned overseas, there's no overseas meaning outside of America, that money can now go back to the foreign parent and not pay tax to America because there's no U.S. connection to it. The whole point of all this tax planning that these U.S. companies are doing right now, they're trying to reduce the taxes from their foreign operations. It does not reduce their U.S. taxes from their U.S. operations.
U.S. the corporate taxes are so high, and in comparison with the international communities, the U.S. government really put their companies in a very disadvantaged position.
America has one of the highest tax rates in the world at 35%. And that's just at the federal level. When you bring in the state level, you're nearing 39% to 40% at some times. So I think the government'sYou know, both sides of the parties here, they understand that the tax rates have to go down. The question is, how do we do that? How do we bring down the tax rate and at the same time not decrease the level of revenue that we're bringing in from businesses?
What did the Treasury did on Monday night?
The Treasury Department, they have limited ability to change the law. They cannot legislate because they're not Congress. But what they can do is they have certain administrative powers under which they can interpret current law and how the law should be interpreted. So what they have done is they have tightened up the rules of doing inversions. They have made the definition of how you qualify to be more difficult, and they've also made the rules more uncertain. Now you can understand these very high-stakes M&A transactions, everyone wants certainty of tax consequences. If there's uncertainty, people get nervous and people don't want to do the transaction anymore. So that's one thing that they've done. The other thing that they've done is for transactions after an inversion, there used to be certain tax benefits that people can take advantage of to reduce their U.S. tax rates. They've now pulled back on those tax benefits such that it won't be as attractive anymore.
What will make the company to change mind? For instance, what we're going to lose if we go ahead with the merger?
Well, there are a lot of announced deals in the public arena right now that are very high profile. The Burger King Tim Horton deal was one that we talked about. They've announced that, you know, regardless of the change in law here, they will continue with their deal because they are not doing it for tax reasons. They see business synergy in doing this deal, so they will continue. Now, the other deals where the companies might have already entered into an agreement, usually for those deals, there's a provision whereby it will say something to the effect that, you know, if it is the case that after this merger, the foreign parent is no longer treated as a foreign parent for U.S. tax law and is instead treated as a U.S. parent, then the parties can walk away from the deal. But you need to keep in mind, that is not the change that the Treasury Department enacted here. The Treasury Department did not go so extreme as to completely shut down inversion to say that after you invert, guess what? We're going to override the law and say we're going to treat the foreign corporation as a U.S. corporation. They are not doing that. They only tightened the definition such that, you know, when counting whether or not you qualify under the test, it's now a little harder and it's a little more ambiguous.
以上就是这节的环球财经，谢谢您的收看。现在将现场交回在香港直播室主播任任。